Good morning students. In this module we will learn about the various motions of the earth, and let's start with the first one, that is rotation. So rotation is the movement of the earth along its axis from west to east, and it takes about 24 hours to complete one rotation or to complete one cycle of the earth moving along its axis. So this is rotation. Rotation leads to the occurrence of day and night. A part of earth which is towards the sun, that is facing the sun, will experience day, and the other side will experience night. And when the earth will rotate further, the side in darkness will come towards the sun, will have day, and the side which was towards the sun will go away and will have night. So like this, the earth rotates in 24 hours from west to east and leads to the occurrence of day and night. Students, there are other effects also of rotation about which we will learn in the next module. So our next motion that is shown by the planet earth is revolution. So revolution is the movement of the earth along its axis, also at the same time in its orbit around the sun. So we can say precisely that revolution is the movement of the earth around the sun in its orbit, and the time taken is 365 days and 6 hours to complete one cycle by the earth around the sun. That is, revolution is completed in 365 days and 6 hours. Children, this is also equivalent to a year. We say one revolution of the earth is a year, is 1 year of the earth. So in this way we also come across the concept of leap year. So what is a leap year? Students, as I said just now, 1 year has 365 days and 6 hours. So that extra 6 hours is carried over, and the 4th year, when we accumulate all the 6 hours and we get it, the total of 24 hours, then it is equivalent to 1 day. So in the 4th year, we add 1 extra day to the month of February, and in non-leap year, February has 28 days, but in a leap year, February has usually it has 29 days. So this is a leap year with one extra day. Usually an year has 365 days, but a leap year has 366 days. So like this, the concept of leap year can be understood. Now students, let's move to the other motions shown by the earth apart from rotation and revolution. Now students, the other motions that are shown by the earth are very, very slow motions, and they do not have any large impact on the human life or life on the planet. Whereas rotation and revolution, they have a huge impact on the life of the human beings or the life on the planet. We will learn about them, as I have told you, in the next module. So let's move to the slow motions of the earth. First one is precession. Now here what happens, the earth, as the earth spins along its axis, it wobbles in the space like a spinning top. So students, you must have seen a spinning top. So if the earth, while moving along its axis or rotating along its axis, also wobbles in the space like a spinning top, and it forms an arc in the sky. And if we see in the space, it forms an arc while it wobbles like a spinning top. And so this motion of earth is very slow, and this is known as precession. So now let's see how much time is taken by the earth to complete one precession. And the time taken is 25,800 years to complete one cycle by the earth, that is to complete one precession. Now students, the next motion the solar system along with the planet Earth in it, it moves around or it revolves around the center of the galaxy. So which galaxy? That is Akash Ganga or the Milky Way galaxy, to which our solar system belong. So the whole solar system actually moves in the galaxy, or it moves around the center of the galaxy, and it takes 3 lakh years, and the speed is 300 kilometers per hour. So this is how the solar system also revolves all around the center of the galaxy. Now the next motion is the motion of the galaxy. So even the galaxy, that is Milky Way galaxy, even our galaxy in which our solar system, our planet Earth belong, so the galaxy also keep moving in the universe. It keeps moving in the universe, and this motion is known as the motion of the galaxy. So students, these are the different motions shown or exhibited by the planet Earth. Now students, we will learn about different related concepts with rotation and revolution. So the first one is the axis. We'll learn about the axis and also about the circle of illumination. Look at this picture. Here you can see the red line passing through the center of the Earth, and the Earth seems to be inclined along it. So this is the axis of the Earth along which it rotates. So the Earth rotates along its axis, and while rotating it makes different angles of Earth's inclination. So let's learn about the angles of Earth's inclination. Students, look at the picture carefully. You will see the axis. You will also find a vertical line which is the perpendicular, and an horizontal line that is dividing the Earth into two equal halves. That is the Earth's orbital plane. So we have three lines: the axis, that is the tilted line, the perpendicular, and the Earth's orbital plane. So these three lines form two angles of inclination. That is, the axis and the perpendicular forms an angle of 23.5, whereas the axis along with the orbital plane makes an angle of 66.5. So students, these are the two angles of Earth's inclination. Now students, next we will learn about the circle of illumination. So what is it? The circle of illumination is an imaginary line which separates light from darkness and day from night. So students, if you notice in this diagram, you can see the Earth, where the half of it is dark, it is in darkness because it is away from the sun, and the another half is towards the sun, it's facing the sun and it is bright and experiencing day. So the circle of illumination is the imaginary line that divides the dark half and the lit half of the Earth. Here is another picture that will make your concept further clear about the circle of illumination. It's drawn very clearly. The shaded portion is showing the part of the Earth away from the sun, and the illuminated or the brighter side is showing the part of the Earth facing the sun. So students, that's all in this module. We will learn more about the effects of rotation and revolution in the next module. Thank you very much.